Hello everyone and welcome to episode number 70 of 5 Games 5 Minutes from acornelectron.co.uk. Elite is the very first incarnation of the legendary space trading game, where the player has complete free will to attain the aim of the game. That is, to gain a rank of Elite. You'll get there only after many hours of play and by striking the right balance between shrewd business operator and souped-up spaceship-driving, feared, gun-toting badass. You need to read the instructions carefully. Firstly, because there are around 30 controls, and secondly, because if you don't, you'll likely end up flying around in space not really knowing what to do. The idea is that you consider the prices of various commodities on your start planet, stock up, launch, and then hyperspace to a nearby planet and sell them, gaining more and more of the in-game currency of credits. Or you could decide to gain credits by blasting every other spaceship you find, of course. There's so much more to this game than that, of course, and Elite has almost been universally considered the number one game of all time. What more can I add to such accolades? Just play it. City Defense is a pretty hard arcade game from Bug Byte, in which you must defend cities from imminent destruction by guided missiles. You can launch rockets from one of three positions by pressing J, K and L, and then you can steer the most recently launched rocket with Funk and Q. Often you're under attack from 10 or so missiles, and there's so much going on that you need a lot of concentration and luck to succeed. The keys are awkward, and that doesn't improve matters. If you lose a gun or two, that's not the end of the game, but if you lose all of your cities, then it's game over. The game's done in machine code, but the graphics are very basic. The cities don't even look like cities. As levels increase, the colour palette changes. Levels done with red as background colour are particularly difficult, because it's so hard to see. All in all, City Defense is a likeable, but difficult game. The Life of Repton is another set of 40 levels designed with the Repton 3 game engine. This time levels have been themed as Baby Repton, Repton at School, Repton as a teenager, Repton as an office worker, and Repton as an old age pensioner. They start off easy and they get steadily more difficult until you reach the ridiculous heights of the later levels. As is usual, the designer tools are also included with the game. The game is quite slickly put together. The graphics are good, and many of the puzzles are difficult to fathom. As with other theme titles in the Repton series though, whether the redesigned sprites help or hinder the game is debatable. When Repton was dealing with boulders and diamonds, we knew where we were. When it's Humpty Dumpties and teddy bears, it's more difficult to work it out. That is, unless you refer to the map, which still has the original Repton 3 sprites. If you're a Repton fan, then you're probably going to be happy enough with what's included here. 2002 A Space Oddity is a text adventure where the scenario is baffling. Apparently you were flying your spaceship, but it crashed, so you were rescued by another spaceship, but everyone on it promptly died. You now need to escape this new spaceship in a, lifeboat. The adventure, a standard north, south, east and west fare, is just as confusing as the scenario. For example, you're told in one location that you're facing lots of dials that you don't know the name of. I thought you said I was a trained space explorer. The oddities littering this spaceship also defy explanation. A Sinclair C5? A book called The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy? Space sickness pills? A sonic screwdriver? It's also far too easy to get into that lifeboat and escape. And why you would fancy your chances on a tiny little lifeboat rather than a fully functioning spaceship is also never explained. Hence, it's just also illogical that there's no sense of achievement. 2002 A Space Stupidity might have been a better title. Jack Attack is a graphic adventure game, loosely based on the fairy tale Jack and the Beanstalk. It's a good example of why you should never attempt to write any kind of arcade game on the Electron in Mode 2. Well, not unless you're a programmer par excellence. Yes, Jack Attack is colourful, but that's about as far as it goes. The sacrifices made to have the colours are too great, with the code powering the game groaning under the weight. The patrolling baddies literally crawl along, and you'll lose 10 seconds of your life every time you enter or exit a screen just watching it all be built up. progress far into the game and you'll enter some seriously dull catacombs where you can easily traverse any number of screens before meeting a dead end. As if this weren't ridiculous enough, the blurb by Bugbyte, the publishers of Jak Attack, states, "The author is John Niblett, so don't blame us for this game, it's his fault." What nonsense! It wasn't him who released it and made us all howl with despair, was it? No, thought not.